This video is the second in a three-part series on the spherical capacitor, and this time we're computing the potential difference between the two conducting shells of the capacitor, and then we're going to find the capacitance of the spherical capacitor. In the previous video, we already found the electric field between the concentric shells of the capacitor using Gauss's law, and that turned out to be E equals Q over 4 pi epsilon 0 r squared. In other words, the same thing as the electric field of a point charge located at the center. And then the electric field was zero inside the inner shell and outside the outer shell. And I'll post a link to that video at the top real quick so you can review the calculation. So the main idea for finding capacitance is that we put charges of plus and minus Q on the two conductors, and then we use the definition of capacitance. And capacitance is Q over V, charge per volt. So if we place those charges of plus and minus Q on the two conductors, and then we find the potential difference between them, that's V, the capacitance drops out immediately by taking Q divided by V. Now, because we already have the electric field between the two conductors, V is going to be computed as a path integral between the two shells. And we choose the simplest possible path between the two shells, which is a radial line segment from a point that I called point number one to point number two. So now the potential difference is given by an integral. So our potential difference V1 minus V2 is given by this path integral from point one to point two of the electric field E dotted into DL, where DL is a small path length increment. And I'll post a link to the video where this path integral formulation of potential difference was first derived. Now we're free to choose the zero of potential, and we normally do this at the lowest potential location in the problem, so that's on the outer shell. So I'm just going to say let V2 equal zero. And then V1, we'll just go ahead and call that V, and our V stands for the potential difference then between the two plates. Now inside of our path integral, we have our electric field vector, which points radially, and then we have that dotted into DL, which is a path length increment along our radial path. That means DL actually points in the radial direction as well, which makes the electric field always parallel to the path length increment. This means the dot product becomes trivial. If two vectors are parallel, then the dot product just becomes the product of the magnitudes. And I think it's helpful here to replace the DL with a DR, just as a reminder that we are moving exactly in the radial direction. So I'm going to call this the integral of E times DR, because we already know the dot product is trivial. And my integration variable must be R, so I'm going to go from the initial value of R to the final value of R as I go from point one to point two. Well, the initial value was A and the final value was B. Now we can plug in our electric field magnitude, and I get the integral from A to B of Q over 4 pi epsilon 0 R squared dr. And that's not such a bad integral. Everything there is constant except for the 1 over R squared, and the integral of 1 over R squared is negative 1 over R. So I have my constants out in front, Q over 4 pi epsilon 0, the antiderivative of 1 over r squared, which is negative 1 over r, and then we evaluate across the limits of integration from a to b. Plugging in the upper limit of integration, I end up with a negative 1 over b, and then the lower limit, I have a double negative there. I'm subtracting this negative thing, so I end up with plus 1 over a. We can clean up this part in parentheses by getting a common denominator, so I'm going to multiply the first fraction by a over a, and the second one by b over b. That gives me a b minus a in the numerator, and then an ab in the denominator. So there's our potential difference between the two conducting shells. It's q times the quantity b minus a over 4 pi epsilon 0 ab. Now remember, the plan was to use the definition of capacitance, that's q over v, where q is the charge magnitude on the two plates, and v is the potential difference between them. So all we have to do is take q and multiply by the reciprocal of our potential difference, V. So in our numerator, we're going to get 4 pi epsilon 0 AB. And in our denominator, we have a Q times the quantity B minus A. The Qs are going to cancel out here. And we find that our capacitance is equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 AB divided by B minus A. So there's the capacitance of the spherical capacitor. In the next video, we're going to calculate the energy stored in this capacitor, and we're going to do this in two different ways. First, we'll use the standard formula for energy stored in a capacitor, that's 1/2 CV squared. And then our second method is a little more exotic. We're going to compute the energy stored in this thing by integrating the electric field energy density in the region between the two conductors. That video is linked at the upper left of the end screen, and I'll see you there.